fellow orphans, welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. We are right in front of Castle Shedungent, and this is essentially the second part of, well, the quest for Medora's freedom. We need to talk to Nulfaaga, and, well, either get a unicorn horn from her, or if she's too, you know, crazed to actually provide us with a horn, we need to, well, actually go to, you know, go through her castle and try and find the unicorn horn ourselves. So yeah, here we go. It's as straightforward as it gets. I have actually went to Koegria. You guys saw that in the last video. And I have restocked on potions. So let's see how this goes. Yeah, I'll just make a save here instead of saving outside. Now, we already know the... right, I think we need to click this. Yeah, shut up, I believe the phrase was. What are these things? Gargoyle? I thought these guys... They were supposed to be knights, not gargoyles. No treasure. Okay, strange. The last time around that we came here, they were knights, not gargoyles. Well, they could certainly gargoyles now. Anyway, time to talk to her. Location of things. Tell me about. Ah, yes, the unicorn horn. The delicate spiral horn curved slightly before ending in a deadly sharp point. You had always heard that unicorn horns were of purest alabaster ivory. This one seems to be more like silver. You are Nulfaaga, yes? I thought you were supposed to provide me with the location of the damn unicorn horn. I suppose I'll just have to go ahead and do things myself then. Yeah, looks like that's what it is. Give me a moment, I'll be back. Yeah, sorry about that. I'm back now. I have to go poop. So this is the guy that we speak the password to when leaving. Anyway, yeah, I doubt there's anything in here. This flag doesn't really... Something happened when I clicked on that flag. I don't know what, but something happened. I'm guessing the treasure lies somewhere over there. The unicorn horn. Doubt there's anything in here. Does not seem to be the case. No, I don't think so. But this place, I hear giant's footsteps. Like the footsteps of a giant. Shaking the earth as he walks. Anyway, let's move on. Try and find a solution. It's strange how there was like a gargoyle guarding that part of the dungeon there. Oh, we're back. Is that a sorcerer? I think that is. Yeah, we're back to human enemies now. Except for that one place where, well, we just found a random sorcerer. Oh, sorry, a random gargoyle. Couple of gargoyles guarding Nulfaaga. Maybe Nulfaaga set them herself, you know. Don't know why I checked that, bothered to check that thing over there. Now, I have no idea what these do actually. But, here we go. They sound like letting down some kind of, I don't know, water thing? Like, the sound of water dripping onto a surface is what it sounds like. But yeah, nothing here either. Now, there is a reason that I'm clicking on everything that I see. And the reason is that I had previously spoiled this for myself. And I do remember the fact that we have to click on some sort of a torch or something in order to open the gate for where we need to head to. So, yeah, that's pretty much the reason why I'm clicking on everything. As far as I recall, I think it was a torch, but I'm not sure whether it was or not. Another sorcerer. Good thing that these guys take time charging up their attacks and don't even, you know, hit that hard to begin with. I see another. Flowers. I can take lots of flowers. So, another. Okay, so I suppose some of these. Oh, wait, there's a mage behind me. I was wondering why. I was wondering whether that thing actually summoned like a fireball at me. I have finished loitering, but I did not actually mean to loiter. I just wanted to rest until I'm mentally fully healed. Ah, another gargoyle. These guys don't really seem to be that tough, but. That did nothing. I wonder if one of these controls this gate here. Okay, so this does nothing except for decrease my health. And this one actually does control the gates. That's good to know. Okay, so I guess unless I see a gate, I'll just leave these things as they are. At this point, I've got no idea where I'm headed. So I suppose in the end, we'll figure things out by trial and error. Another gargoyle. I wonder why there are so many gargoyles spawning. Like, these guys are low loot and they don't really seem to be attacking me as often either. Don't know what's the deal with them, but here we are. Here we find ourselves in a. Wait, is this the torch that I'm supposed to be touching? I think not. I hear something that I've never heard before. But at any rate, I do not think that this is the torch that we were supposed to be touching. The torches are just super low in this section right here, which makes me wonder as to what exactly I'm getting into here. Now the torches are at normal height. Like, something seems strange about those torches. Just their height for the most part. Mage. Okay, these guys hit hard. My god. You know what? Let me try just resting here. Of course, I cannot rest. Healing. Potion of healing. That's my only option right now. I got lots of potions just in case we might need them. Slow falling, cure poison, cure poison, cure poison. Free action. Okay, healing. Legendary gold. And any flowers that I might have. Helps in demarcating where I need to go. Yeah, I think, like, this is essentially all part of the same path. Stutter stepping. Like, I want to know how hard these guys hit, but they don't seem to be attacking at all. So, there's that. I wonder if this guy has any treasure. Of course he does not. This will, of course, just take me all the way back here. Another sorceress for us to stay. Okay, that's a huge enemy spam. I wonder why. The gargoyle attacked, but did not seem to hit me for whatever reason. I bet only the sorcerer will have any actual loot, but doesn't have to check, or so I would suppose. treasure, as expected. Now, this module I'm a little familiar with from my previous incursion into these areas. They typically don't have anything. There is, however, something to look up to. To put things in a way. But this module is adamantium saber. We could sell that for some money. And let me get that flower. So there are two gargoyles over on that side. Now here's the thing, this module is... Well, I guess I'll see you later. Oh, hi there! Sort of missed you. So this module is the exact same as the module that we had previously found ourselves in. In Direnni Tower, this will lead to like a place, as will this will lead to like a different place. The question is, which way do I want to go? Which way do I want to explore? Of course, I cannot rest here, but I do believe that I can save at this point. I don't even know whether I am going the correct way or not. This is just some random loot. Wait a minute. Oh, so this is probably where I came from. Right then. Righty then. Before I head there, I just want to check what's beyond this door. It seems to be another passageway. I'll leave this for later. Hoping that that is not actually the correct path for us to take. Now, I'm in half a mind to actually crawl this dungeon, like crawl this module. I do not think this is where our objective would be, but, well, you never know. You never know, to be honest. Okay, there's like a closed door here. We need to figure out lever for this if we want to proceed ahead, like proceed beyond that point. But, let me assume, this is the lever. Seems to be the case. What would you know? Okay, okay. Two mages, that's asking. Like, that's too much to ask for. From anybody, you know? Like, two entire mages, come on. Balance your encounters, would you? Yeah, I'm just gonna hold on to this. That seems enchanted, that shield. Maybe it has spell reflection or something? I do not know, honestly. And since I don't really do guesswork, I'm just gonna get it identified later on. And in the unfortunate circumstance that this current shield of our breaks, we have something to fall back upon. My stealth has improved, and so has my long blade. Okay, the gargoyle has died. I'm healed. Saving in... Let's override this slot. Okay, so it's the sound of gargoyles. The sound. Heavy footsteps. I doubt this has any hidden doors. It does not seem to have any hidden doors. At least this level does not have any vampire ancients, because that would just be... That would be too much. That would be too much to handle. Those things still give me nightmares. And the fact is that all the vampire ancients and liches in that level... Well... They are a handful. They are indeed a handful. Okay, two paths that we can take. Let's take the right path, just to, you know. Where are we right now? I have no clue, to be honest. Which path do we want to take? Let's go this way. drop one here, let me drop another one here. I can see another lever. I don't really know what the lever does though. And there's yet another teleporter. Which I assume is a teleporter. Unless it's exactly like Direnni Tower. Yeah, it's just a bricked up door. This, I assume, will move this further so that it opens up an entrance. A door, rather. That we can use to traverse this cursed labyrinth. Why would I hear this guy stomping around so much? Is there another around me? Well, that seems like the only reasonable explanation at this point. These doors are usually, like, they lead to no end, so might as well go ahead and clear them out. Let's search you. I have to admit though, as lethal as they are, mages are pretty. This will of course lead us into an entirely different area. Apparently an area that we've been to before. Right. You know, we can just go through here instead. No need to go all the way back. So this area was a dead end. We just need to look at this area and see where this area takes us. If at all, anywhere. This is presumably a rest area. Look at the knockback, my god, and this guy, when he dies, he spills his offals everywhere, doesn't he? Here's the... like, there's a lever here, and I'm uncertain as to what it does. Let me go ahead and save in the emergency slot, just to be certain. In case it just decides to kill me or whatever. Did it do something? Did it, like, open something up or something? I don't know what it did, but it most certainly did something. Candle here. Yeah, I don't think it did anything, not as far as anything that's in front of us is concerned. I think I might have an idea about what it did, and I think it just locked this door here, if I'm not wrong. I'm just, like, this is just a stretch to be honest, but yeah, it did. It locked this door here. That's all it did. A long way back. But yeah, that's better in the off position. Now to explore this side of the dungeon. Since I feel like I haven't saved... actually, I have saved in the emergency slot. Now which way do we go? Let's explore this level itself first, then we'll go downstairs. I hear a gargoyle. Okay, that's a lot of loot. Now I wonder why I'm getting so much loot. If this is supposed to be some sort of trap, I wonder. Is there something here? No? Like, I swear, without a map, this game would be brutal to play through. this section, it reminds me of another Gargoyle. A mage. She blasted something at me, but well, good thing it did not hit me. Okay. You, sir, need to calm down. One hit and you're down, but you need to calm down. Like, these guys are at par with literal vampire ancients when their attack power is considered, you know? Like, my god, these guys hit hard. Let me go and override the savior. Is there anything down there that we have? Yeah, I feel like there are some areas that we have not searched yet, but we'll get to them. I feel like this will lead us back there anyway. Like these here sections. I feel like these are left unexplored, so. Might as well, right? Okay, another mage. Draining me of all my power as soon as I enter your range. That's not cool, you know, not cool at all. There. I hear a gargoyle somewhere around me. Have you been here before? Seems to be the case, yes. Just another alternate path for us to take upstairs. Like, take to reach upstairs. Okay, now, where will we headed again? We already visited that area, it ended in nothing. And then... we have already been there. Been there, done that. Been there, done that as well. So I suppose this is the only chamber that we have not checked out yet. This way. Right then. Process of elimination. As much as I would like to call it that, I know that this is essentially just... I have no idea what that was. I just picked it up. Could it just be like a pointless recipe of something? It's new. So is this? Doesn't really make sense to change it out for anything. Hi there, gargoyle. I wonder why I was stalking the area like that. Is this the torch? Oh wait, this is the torch. I don't know what opened there, but something opened somewhere. Or at least I hope this was the torch. I don't know, something happened. So I assume... I have no idea what just happened, but something happened. I'll just go upstairs and check to see if anything changed. I honestly don't know where to go at this point. This does not seem to be the place. Oh, hi, sorcerer. It's the first time a sorcerer has landed a hit on me. Quite literally the first time. Good job! Well done, sorcerer. I hear another gargoyle, but I do not know where this gargoyle is. Probably somewhere over there. I'm just gonna try this torch. Oh. So it literally opens up this door for me, I see. Wait, what? Okay, you had like a potion of invisibility cast on you. I can rest here until I'm fully healed, but there are enemies nearby. Of course, there's like a random sorcerer right here. Okay. And would you believe it? I had only read that you're supposed to like touch horns and stuff in this place, but I had never imagined walking into this thing so easily. And that's a horn. That is literally what we came here for. Now, I do know the way to a degree, to an extent. We head back here. And then, how do we escape from this area then? Is now the question. Take this route and yeah, let's basically take it one step at a time. This is where we need to get back, so we'll take it one step at a time. Head straight at the T junction, we take a right. This is the T-junction, and we hang a right here. And I do believe, yeah, let's just keep going until we reach a crossroads straight again. I do believe this is where we have to go. Okay, I see where we're going. Like where we are going with this. There's a gate here. Like it should have been gated, but it wasn't. Or we could have just taken the shortcut here. Shouldn't have been the need for us to walk all the way over here. Now, here's the thing. Do we go there? No, we don't. We just keep straight, and then where to now? That's a question. But that is definitely the wrong way to go. So what we need to do is get south. Go south essentially. So we essentially go straight, follow this route here. And this should, yeah, it essentially leads us to freedom. So we head straight. And then we essentially follow the route to the south, which should be this one. Now what? We have not been right yet, so we need to take a left. And I do believe this takes us to the throne room, and consequently the entrance of the dungeon. Nah, I'm gonna exit this place. Green haze makes my eyes burn. Alright, so I'll make a save here, since that's a job well done. However, what I want to do is pull out my wagon and keep some of my stuff here, some of the things that I found. This, I think, I do not know what it is, yes. So I'll just keep this over here as well. And I do not believe I've found anything else. Yeah, I hadn't really found anything else. Letter of credit, chameleon form. I'll keep this in here as well. Letter of credit. Okay, now that leg of the journey is done, let us go ahead and travel to, where was it again? Direnni Tower. This is going to be another long journey, but here we go. Am I really gonna have to walk all the way around the tower just to find where to enter it. Anyway, as long as I can enter it, that is. This is going to be a rough journey, so wish us luck. We're going to need every ounce of it. Oh, here's the thing. I do not... Yep. None of our clock is saved. Can we... Thank you. I'll just save the game here. Because it's pretty easy to... Well... get knocked off ledges and stuff. From what I've seen. Thus far, at least. Anyway, moving down. There should be like a couple of vampires here. Like, these are essentially the people that we need to be cautious about. And not just these guys, I mean, these guys are the easy ones. We need to be cautious about the vampire ancients. Those guys will fuck you up. Oh, that's interesting. 1008 loot. 1008 gold, rather. Okay, so we came down that ladder, we need to go up this ladder, and first flywheel right here. We ignore the rest of the five wheels and go all the way up. Ooh, interesting, but I cannot carry any more stuff. That is quite sad, because this would have sold for money, you know? This would have sold for like a decent amount of money. Daedric Axe. Actually, I need a Daedric Axe. What can I drop here? What can I discard here? I wonder. How heavy is this? 14 to 24. Wait. 7.5 kgs. So what can I discard? What can I drop? 7 kilograms. Can I like remove these arrows? Because I'm not going to be using them anyway. Okay. Let me drop like 500 gold. Okay, how much? 500 more. Yeah, let's try now. 500. I still cannot carry anymore. Good. Now, yeah, not as much. But I do get like a battle axe to use, so that's nice. I wonder what my long blade is at. I suppose we can start grinding up our axe now. Let's equip this, and you know what, I just quickly want to go back upstairs and deliver this to my sword, rather, to my inventory. Wait, what's this? No, that's the one where I had to go. Yeah. Yeah, I want to access my wagon, and I want to keep this in my wagon. Now let me go back up and loot that vampire. What I want to do is essentially pick these up. Oh, of course I cannot. I wonder why I cannot do that. Info 7 kilograms. Yeah. Arrows are a little difficult to come by in this game. You know what? Let me just go and do this. Let me drop like 500 more gold and see if that frees up enough space to where we can loot these arrows. Wait, what? Is she like sitting atop like a pile of loot or something? Seems to be the case. Fuck it. We'll just find more arrows elsewhere. So what we want to do is go all the way up. And okay, there are a couple of crates here, which is a first for me. And we'll find like a flywheel inside. That we need to hit to unlock the trapdoor at the bottom. Now, oh no! Ah, safe. Amazingly enough, I'm safe. Nothing happened to me. Of course, there are enemies nearby. Now, what I would like to do is save right here. Once more, because I am going to a area that which has literally no mercy. This next area right here, no mercy whatsoever. So I'm gonna pre-pop some potions here. One of them is a potion of resist fire, and another. Actually, for these, I'm pretty sure that we can make do with just resist fire, because liches, I do believe, use fire spells. Okay, of course. I'm paralyzed. Imp just died. I don't know, probably from the effect of the lich. The lich has finally died. Previously, when I dropped here, there were two liches. This time around, there was only one. Which is good. Which is definitely good. I hear more things, more quite objectionable things, but I will not be resting here. I will instead save the game here, and we'll proceed through this door. There's a hidden door right here, which I do believe is the correct path to take. Unless I am of course mistaken, which can very well be the case. A case of mistaken identity. I do believe the correct path to go was upstairs. I wanna keep updating the save, just in case I get into an enemy encounter that can kill me. Unless we're going the wrong way right now. I don't remember whether this was the right way to go or not. I just recall there being only like a few ways that we could take, and this was one of those. The fact that I am unable to rest at this point sort of makes me nervous, but well, it is what it is. Yeah, the scratch attack that she does, it deals a lot of damage. Now, I do believe I've said this before, but what does a vampire have need of a steel short bow? Like, why would you need that? Okay, that's a wraith. Like, it's the first time I've seen crouching wraiths, and that's an imp, apparently. Or a dragon link, whatever. Yeah, there's a dragon link right on my head. Can't really rest here. Yeah, good thing. I see a vampire right behind us, and I'm not going to open that lock. Now, yeah, I think this was the part that we follow. I'm not quite certain, but I think this is the part for us to follow. Right. This is one of the ways out. So we just flip the switch, and we're essentially supposed to go this way, if I'm not wrong. There are of course enemies nearby, so we cannot rest here yet. I just recall the fact that I had to take another right at some point in time, and yeah, this will essentially move this flywheel up and let us access, well, another part of the map. However, if we choose to do that, then we are essentially making things more difficult for us, so we're not going to do that until fully healed. I can thankfully rest here, even if it was for just a while. A vampire here. Yeah, like I said, that scratch attack does a ton of damage. Cannot carry any more stuff, so I'll just pick this flower from you. Let me rest here until I'm healed. Thank you very much. Saving in an alternate slot, just because. Yeah, I'm not gonna... I think the place where the bottle was kept was the right way to go. Although I'm not entirely certain about that, but I do feel like that is the case. I cannot carry any more loot. This might be a moot point to even try. No, I do not recall these areas for the most part. What I do know, however, is that somewhere along this line, along these lines, we'll essentially stumble onto that place that we visited previously. So, here's to hoping for that, and well, proceeding onwards. What's strange is the fact that I can hear these vampires now. Like, when I'm sneaking around, I can hear these vampires. That's a ghoul, or rather a wraith, with a dead end. I do not think this is the baby that we came previously. But doesn't hurt to check, I suppose. Good thing that I saved it, because when the vampirians arrive, you have got no choice whatsoever. Like, literally no choice. I have, however, my to just open UESP wiki and check out where we need to go. Wait, was this where we were supposed to be? No? Right. We were supposed to be on this safe slot. Like, I had half a mind to just open up USB wiki and check where to go, but I decided against it. And I said to myself, nah, let's try doing this the correct way around. I think that's the way. I think this is the way. No, it's not. It's the wrong side. We're at the wrong place. We took a wrong place somewhere, we took a wrong turn somewhere along the way. We're not supposed to be here. This is the wrong place to be. I like how there's like a little tip to the axe so that we can poke people with it. I do recall that we did not have to open any doors to get to where we were going, so I'll not even try to do that. Because I think this door essentially leads us to the triangle down there, and that is not a place that I want to go. Seems to be a place that we have previously visited. Time to head back then. Curious, we have not been here yet. So let us try going here, even though I do believe this will take us down to the triangle. Oh no, this takes us elsewhere. I mean, going up here was the play. It was just, instead of going all left, we had to take a right turn somewhere. That is a Daedra seducer. What is a Daedra seducer of all things doing here? And a vampire ancient, so I'm not gonna go over to that side. You guys know me that well. So, like, you guys know me well enough to know that I'm not gonna be doing that all that, so. Yeah, we'll go this way. And there are a few other paths that we can take here. For example, now here's the thing. If I recall correctly, If I recall correctly, it was quite much further south, the place that we had to go to. And this here section sort of looks a little strange to me. Oh yeah, right, this is the top of the triangle. And is there a wall there, per chance? No, we just have not explored that section in its entirety. So you know what? We'll go here and... we've got a few options here. We can either... that takes us to the triangle, so that's of course not the way to go. We can go here, wherever that takes us, or we can go down this path. Alternatively, we can go down this path as well. But I do recall us hanging right at some point instead of left, and that made all the difference in the world. Maybe it's this path here? I guess we can go ahead and check. Nothing's stopping us, right? Yeah, we go straight, we go all the way. Oh, right. This is that path. Right. So, over here, we keep going straight. But after a certain point, we... Let's try going here and seeing what's up with what. So this is a dead end. Good to have that marked on the map. Now, this path here, yeah, there's a wraith here. Seems like we haven't really visited this path here. That path ends in a dead end, but this path here, this is also a dead end. Oh yeah, this is the path, right. We did actually have to open up a couple of gates to get here. Let me go ahead and save here, because we have made significant progress. Hi there, Wraith. Now, speaking of, I actually haven't been paralyzed in a long while, and I wonder if it's because of the shirt of wisdom that I'm wearing. But yeah, I have not been paralyzed in a long while. These are all pointless corridors. We do not have to... Vampire, I did not expect to see you here. Why are you here, vampire? 602 gold, thank you for giving me your money, your lunch money. I do hope this is the path to go. No, this is not the way that I want to go. Oh wait, this... here it is. Here it is, if I'm not wrong. It is. This is the path that we are supposed to take. There should be a coast around here. And as... oh yeah. Here you are. Save versus spell made. And I'm just gonna save here. The emergency slot. Because I do believe this was the solution to the puzzle, if I'm not wrong. A little bit of trial and error and everything seems a-okay. Now before I go there, I just want to pre-pop a potion of resist fire. That should be good enough against a lich, to be honest. Not a raid. Okay, so I'm paralyzed with lich instead, so that's good. I'm just gonna take and pop in a potion of reaction. There are enemies nearby. Who's the enemy that's nearby? Medora. Yeah. You have succeeded in a most dangerous enterprise, Grimfangs, but many more such trials await you. By bringing the horn to me, you have helped me lift the curse of the... You have helped me lift the curse the Dowager Queen placed on my tower. Why can I not speak today? Maybe it's because it's past 1 o'clock in the night. I hope I can count on you for further aid. For now, take this short sword, as it were. A short sword, really? Do I even have... Of course, I do not have the space for this. Now, what do we drop? What can we possibly humanly drop, is the question. Nothing. Nothing at all. Like, I can't drop anything. 3.75 kilograms? I don't know. 2500? Yeah, thank you. I wish there was a better way of figuring out what to drop, but oh well. Saving again in the emergency slot, at least we now know the way out. I hear something of a vampire ancient, but I'm not gonna waste my time with it. Our efforts now are going to be in escaping this place as expediently as possible. And I do believe this was the less hassle, like the way with the lesser hassle. Nah, opposite way. Yeah. And yeah, we just keep heading south, and this is the way we go. Now, how do we get out again? We follow this path here, and then what? We need to head down a level, that is for certain, but where is the path for us to head down is the question. And it's a good question at that, it's a pretty good question. I do believe this was the staircase. I'm not gonna... I mean, I could make a run past those vampire ancients, that's for certain. This is where the vampire ancients... we'll find the vampire ancients, rather. I could just make a break past them. But at any rate, this seems to be the path for us to take. Question is, how do we get there? Okay, this is the path for us to take, so for now we just reach this point by heading straight, heading west, and once we get to the door, we keep heading west, and right. I can hear lots of monsters there, but I'm just gonna ignore them for the most part. And yeah, right, this is the other way for us to take. There's a vampire there that I can hear that I'm gonna completely ignore. Almost stumbled and fell over that box there. Now then, now that we're here, right, we take a left. I mean, there's only one way for us to go at this point. Until we reach another junction, and we pop in a potion of levitation, and we get the fuck out of here. I do believe that I have got at least one, because I made sure to buy one. Otherwise, it would have been difficult. Difficult dwellings for me. And that is the way out for us, so that is the way we go. Yeah, this is the way out, so... Nah, I won't exit this accursed place. Dry bones littered everywhere, a huge bat does something to me which I don't even understand what. But that seems like a journey well done. That seems like, honestly seems like a journey well done. And... we're going to Koegria. Because we need a bit of respite. The problem is, now see, this is essentially what really frustrates me about this branch, if I am getting it right, which I do believe I am. The fact that axe backstabbing, critical strike improved, that is extremely nice, that is very nice. Venom antidote and cloth amulet, dragonish of course. Of course not, I want to keep that on me. A diamond of venom antidote, cure poison, shocking shock. How shocking. Right then. So yeah, this is what essentially frustrates me about this, is the fact that every single time that I have to go meet Medora, I have to literally go all the way back into the Direnni Tower just to meet her. And we have to go through all of that again, figuring out the path. I mean, we'll get better at it with time, but we still have to deal with all those troubles and foes. And those are one of the strongest enemy types in this game. It's not like these enemies will get easier with time. I mean, I'm level 14, I'm not that strong yet. But even if I was, those enemies are insanely powerful. Insanely powerful. So yeah, I honestly don't know what to do. Oh yeah, I completely forgot about these. I've got like a Torque of Ice Storm and an Amber of Venom Antidote for whatever use that might be. I'm just picking up all the potions that I have in my inventory. Parchment use. Ah yes, this one. Right, the quest that I never went for. I don't know how to sell these. Anyway, what I was saying is, it takes up a lot of effort. It takes a lot of effort just to go ahead and make our way to her, only for us to, you know, exit the damn place. And the only reward is the loot gained from killing those monsters in and of itself, which, to be frank, isn't a lot. Which isn't really a lot of loot to begin with. So yeah, it's a pretty unrewarding kind of experience, if you ask me. But well, it is what it is. I guess it's just the grindy part of the game. I'm looking forward to playing these missions, especially with shorter dungeons enabled in DFU. Although I don't know whether that works on main quest dungeons or not. But I do hope they do cut out the pointless modules of the dungeons, at least. But at any rate, this is it for today's video. This was the second part of Medora's Freedom, which actually got over pretty quicker than I anticipated it would. You know, we did it faster than I thought we would do it. Like, it didn't take as long as I thought it would. But anyway, when we come back, we will be branching off from the main quest in order to go back to Verest and, well, complete some quests for the Knightly Order, the Order of Rose. So I'm basically looking to get my final promotion, which is the promotion to Seneschal. Yeah, we're in Seneschal. We hold the rank of Seneschal right now. I want to be promoted to the rank of Paladin in the Knights of the Rose. And yeah, let's see how many quests we have to do for that, whether that might be one quest or two quests or however many. But at any rate, when we come back, we will be tackling that questline, like the Knights of the Rose questline, or whatever quest they throw at us. The quest that they gave us previously got us Aureal Shield, but as it turns out, you can only get one of those quests in your lifetime, unless you have some of the other kind of setting or mod enabled or setting, you know, tampered with. So at any rate, for this video, this is it. When we come back, we'll take on Knightly Order quests, a quest for the Knights of the Rose. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow earthlings.